Hi folks, it's been a week where drought and the effects of drought have been forefront in the Australian media, and so it should, with large parts of New South Wales and half of Queensland in a very serious drought. We welcome the fact the federal government has announced a $190 million special package to assist our farmers, but we also acknowledge that people in the towns themselves are doing it tough. A lot of those people rely on trade from farmers, or indeed are employed on farms. So it's not just the farmers, as tough as it is for them, it's all communities in those drought affected areas that are really struggling. And even councils themselves. It costs more to make a road, we know that. If we're trying to maintain or build a road, we've got to cart water from a lot further. So it impacts pretty much everything. As a kid who grew up in the country, I understand the deprivations. I've been one of those people that's had to share the bath water as a child. Everyone just does their bit. And at the LGAQ, we're focusing on the immediate. We're working with people like the Red Cross, who we met with just this week. We're also working with some of the other aid agencies to ensure that we get the best and most coordinated campaign for our rural communities. But we're also focusing on the future. And because of that, the LGAQ has run some initiatives over the past few years that deal with the reality of climate change. We're not into who caused it or who's to blame. We're simply about getting on with it. And the Queensland Resilient Councils Group, run by Doreen Earhart, is a great example of practical ways how can we deal with higher temperatures that might affect the life of a road seal. How do we plan our communities better? How do we create shade spaces? And equally, through our $14 million state government funded QCoast initiative, QCoast 2020 initiative, we're looking at how councils can prepare for sea level rises into the future. What planning and other things do they have to do? What other practical measures do they have to implement? So we acknowledge that drought is absolutely real. The good thing is, of course, as people know, the LGAQ is not charging subscriptions to those councils that are members of LGM, LGW. So that takes a little bit of pressure off those councils that are under the pump. We think of those people, and we're certainly standing beside our rural communities as they go through a dreadful drought.